Here we are at Glick's, and here is the redoubtable Mr. Glick.
Now, Mr. Glick, how long have you been in business?
38 years.
38 years. It doesn't look a day over 37.
That's right. And you've made more than 37 bagels in that time.
A bit more.
Now, we were talking about the mini bagels that are new and very popular at the moment. This is the mini.
This is tiny.
But that's you've got a smaller one.
Yes, tiny.
It's awesome. You can taste and you tell me how is this.
Thank you, taste.
If you eat a bagel like this.
And look at the price.
Get the bargain.
The price is very cheap. They're 50 cents a bagel. And if you buy 10 bagels, they're 450. Only.
That's a deal from Deal Land.
They're not oily.
I'm sorry.
They're not oily, okay. And they're healthy.
No oil.
These won't kill you.
No triple bypasses. No oil.
All of the food here is guaranteed to keep you alive until you bleach you get hard.
Until you die.
Been said already, but for my part, I think that he did indeed bring a touch of feeling to the great office of the Governor Generalship. I didn't know him personally, although I'd met him once or twice. He was a great Australian, and I guess the thing that I'm particularly conscious of today is that along with Sir John Monash and Sir Isaac Isaacs, he has probably been the greatest Jew that Australia has produced. And given the extraordinary qualities of the Jewish people, that makes him a remarkable man indeed. Jewish people like to observe Australia is the one country on earth apart from Israel where you've had a Jewish head of the army, a Jewish head of the judiciary, and a Jewish head of state. So,
it's pretty remarkable. We are fortunate to live in such a free country.
I'm told I've got to go.
Thanks,
good to
Tony
see you. Abbott.
His appointment was probably the best appointment I've ever made.
Good on you. Thanks, Mel.
Sir Zelman's an iconic figure of Australian history. Not just the Jewish community, he belongs to all of the Australian people.
What I wanted to ask you about was, what do you think the legacy of Sir Zelman Cowen was?
Well, I think he will leave a profound, or has left a profound legacy. Principally, in his role as Governor General, he restored the public's faith and trust in that office. That was extremely important to the stability of Australia then, as it is now. Secondly, in terms of education, he elevated legal scholarship as well as tertiary education to a new level, and I think that has going to have a profound impact on many, many people for years to come. And speaking at a personal level, as one of those people who were mentored by Sir Zelman, he was an inspiration. And he always taught us to think for ourselves and the importance of principles and values. And for me, in my career and in my life, I keep thinking back to what Sir Zelman taught me as a guide, as a roadmap for my years to come.
Well, the reason why Tony Abbott and Julie Bishop support Israel is because they understand that it's in Australia's national interest, that they're actually siding with a country who shares its democratic values. Mm. I mean, that's what's at the heart of it, Henry, is that Israel has democratic values, which Australia shares. And that's why Israel and the United States are also great friends.
But our success and our prosperity and our health and our survival as a race, as a religion, as a people, is actually dependent not on Israel. It's actually dependent on the strength of our community at a grassroots level.
Jews are not necessarily the kind of people who live in the past. We love the modern and the new. In fact, Sergey Brin of Google and Mark Zuckerberg of Facebook, both nice Jewish boys. So we love modern modes of communication and we try and pioneer. But there are certain things that never change. And the Torah is eternal, and in each generation we have found it so. And there is no object that we revere more than a Torah scroll.
As a valued advisor, your guidance on any given issue has never failed to be of practical value and deeply grounded in the kind of wisdom that is increasingly hard to come by. We all pray that you will enjoy the happiest and most fulfilling of semi-retirements, and that you will do so with our affectionate wishes ringing in your ears.
Inspiration from world leaders like Lord Rabbi Jonathan Sacks is positive and healing, and his teachings have to be highly regarded. To forgive and to be able to find solutions to challenges that have beset mankind throughout history is indeed a blessing. Here at The Shtick, we believe that racism and intolerance of any kind comes from a lack of education or accurate information. And so our Shtick mission has become to inform and educate our audience so as to hopefully prevent anti-Semitism or racism or any form of bigoted vilification. We believe in freedom of speech. We believe in human rights. We believe in loving all our neighbours.
And what made you move back to Melbourne?
Music. My musical family is in Melbourne, and probably the only Jew or the only other Jew in show business at the time was Michael Gudinski, and I ended up signing with his label, which was a really innovative label back in those times. Michael was the first independent record company, and it was a big honour to be on that label. So I met up with Michael to this day, Michael and Frank Stivala, who runs the agency that Michael owns with him, I'm very close with them. So it's kind of like a family. My music family's here and my relative family are in Sydney.
Deborah Conway and Willy Zygier.
Hello, Henry.
Nice intro. Like it.
We are regulars.
Short and sweet.
You are.
You've been on before.
Numbers of times.
I've used your clips a lot too, mm-hmm. whether you give me approval or not, because I know you would anyway.
Henry, you don't need approval.
We do a gig.
Fast track.
Henry
it.
Is there.
Yeah.
We have carte blanche.
Yeah, exactly.
And I've probably got the greatest archive of your music.
Perhaps
on video, I think I have.
I think that could be argued.
Mm. Welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick, and I'm going to introduce you to a nice Jewish goy. What's your shtick?
My shtick is that I'm a Yiddish actor. You'd like to know more about it?
I'd like to, especially seeing that you've come all the way from New York City.
Well, I'll tell you, when I got the call to appear here on The Shtick, I felt like I'd fallen into a tub full of rendered chicken fat.
And we just saw that you let down Jay Leno, you let down David Letterman, you let everybody down just to come and be on The Shtick.
I had to be here.
Yeah.
This is where I wanted to be.
She took an uncommercial sound to new places. She was a great live performer. Whereas there's so many artists that can make great records that can't perform live. In the early days, she loved touring, but touring could become a real mind and grind, etc. But look, I'm just proud that she was proud to be Jewish and never hid it. And I think that her legacy has been what her brother's achieved here, and the fact he didn't go in the media a lot was such a great thing. And what they've achieved with this whole thing is to show that this real girl was not sex, drugs and rock and roll.
You are a product of Je suis Juif.
Thank you very much.
You
yes,
are.
It was. Mm. It's been quite a...
The turning point.
It was.
Yep.
It is. There may be more turning points to come, who knows, but it's certainly one of them.
But it's made you a dutiful Jew.
I'm very dutiful. I think. Yeah. I think, and so are you, Henry.
Especially to the media. That's our shtick.
What we do. It's what we do. I think. Yeah. I think the more contact we can have, the better. It's been.
It's that kind of world. We're living in a media outlet.
We're drinking it all the time.
Just there's like social media, you know, internet media, business, war, drugs. No, everything's going on around us.
No,
you know, murder.
I'm altogether nervous at the thought of what could come forward. But I want to be a part of telling the story.
Well, we want to be part of the good news.
Now, what happened in prison, which after interrogation, I said, yes, I thought they would release me now. So they said, you have to go to prison for a short period of time. Otherwise, you would be exposed that you work for us. And in prison, this is when I witnessed the torture. And actually, I told Hamas the truth, that the Israelis approached me and they're desperate to hire me. And I think this is a great opportunity to take advantage of it. And they said, no, you're crazy. You know, your father's reputation, anyone else can do this type of job, but not you. Because the damage that you could cause is much worse than any productive thing you think about.
Hey, brothers and sisters, do not forget, in this Chanukah, without the candle and without the donuts and without the Chanukiah, you have to find another things to light. The shtick light. So shtick my Chanukiah in this Chanukah, shtick my donuts, shtick my Sevivon, and for all the Christian, my brothers and sisters, shtick Santa Claus on the tree. So happy Chanukah Christmas, and shtick me 100 times. One of my candles fall down on the floor. Oy, the shtick metziah.
גלגל הוא מתגלגל למטה למעלה מרכבות סתומות הולכות ומתגלגלות קול נעימות עולה ויורד תק ומשתק בעולם אוי 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 זה הכל
Beautiful, Manny.